So we have restructured again once more our timetable because we'll be finishing by 3:15, more or less, 3:15, more or less. And so instead of doing some kind, we decided to do the closure and the ending of this. Since we have been in the small groups, we thought it was a good opportunity to come back to the large group to do the closure and to finish. And you came here with 3 points about culture and whoever, and there have been many things happening in these 2.5 days. So I think it's a good idea that everyone closes the way he or she wants to close. Penso che voi, se vuoi traduco io quello che ho detto, va bene? Sì, sì, no, tranquilla. Allora, solo per gli italiani, volevo dire che abbiamo ricambiato programma un'altra volta e visto che chiuderemo per le 3:15 e visto che i gruppi sono durati un pochino più a lungo, adesso facciamo un attimo la chiusura di questi 2 giorni. Ci sono state tante cose successe, tanti stimoli, tante riflessioni. E semplicemente chiudiamo qua nel gruppo grande l'esperienza in qualche modo, no? Quindi chiudiamo, facciamo la chiusura qui. So we'll be doing the closure here. At the end I would like also some of you who have thought about going to Brazil, just even the orientation, just to mention it to Renato and Meg, and then other people will follow and do it afterwards. But who has an idea already now, I think it's a good time to say it before we finish the conversations. So I think it's nice to have everybody who feels like making a comment, and we give the closure to this encounter.
For me, this has been a very rich learning experience. Through great discomfort from my flight being cancelled all the way to now. And I would like to close with a poem from an English poet, William Blake. He's a 19th century poet. And this poem encapsulates some of my important learning from this weekend. So it's a very short poem, okay? So it says, he who bends to himself a joy doth the winged life destroy. But he who kisses joy as it flies lives in eternity's sunrise. Lives in eternity's sunrise. So, for me, in this context here, in my final learning conversation with colleagues in the smaller group, I was talking about my business, which is called Glorious Imperfection. It's my coaching business. And one of the things I have been trying to understand the significance of for maybe 3 years is the idea I had that provisionality, there's something about provisionality that is important and powerful. So the idea that provisionality is not weakness, provisionality is possibility. And in our group, Trudy was able to put this into the TA framework of the palimpsest, pre-script, pre-rules. And for me, this is where my real learning has been and has expanded my frame of reference to what my work is and where my work is and why I think time and pace matters, because these are the drum of the heartbeat below the words, the rules, all of these things. Yeah. And also,
can you say that again?
I couldn't hear, sorry. So this explains to me why my instinct is that time and timing, both of interventions and when things happen, systemic in systems and also in individuals, why this is important, because the heartbeat and the rhythm, the drum rhythm, is below, is in the palimpsest, in the conditions for palimpsest. And also, I think for me as well, why I was silent this morning, that in the silence is another condition for the palimpsest. It's pre-language. So in terms of thinking of culture and difference in culture, this is of great interest to me, how to invite diversity into a space. This seems significant to me. And this is part of my learning journey, so I don't know where I will go with this, but I have somewhere to go. So I thank you all. Did you want to say something, Rosemary?
I didn't quite understand. You're talking about the wordless level of prescript.
Yeah?
The protocol.
Nice.
Before.
First is protocol and then palimpsest. But it's not wordless. So I was confused.
Oh God, my TA theory's wrong. Yeah, sorry. Anyway, is there's provisionality. There's pre and provisionality. Anyway, silence and is significant for me.
Okay, I'll take this.
Thank you.
What I learned in these days was on different levels. One level is that I observed the facilitators assuming a role of facilitate in a non-facilitating way, or in a way which is not, where the goal is not visible, I would like to thank you for this model, which gave me a few ideas of how to do or of how not to do this. And especially today in the small group before lunch, we talked about recognition, and the other word was
appreciation.
Yeah, and I guess I would really appreciate you, the three persons who were initially the founders of this learning events, and you two who took more the lead now. And I'm full of questions, partly with answers, partly without answers, and that's a good way to go away. Thank you.
Maybe I'll follow. Thank you. My experience of today is of a very profound understanding in the small group. And so that's why I want to pick up on what Rona said about provisionality. Because we came up with something, and I want to check this with Cesare before I expound it too much. The phrase that we came up with was to describe what's been happening here over 3 days was temporary imperfections. Well, isn't it? Isn't it? It's beautiful.
Temporary
imperfections. Yeah. And we were very much in that space of wanting to understand each other and beginning to understand how words can get in the way because we load them differently according to our cultures. And we were able to go through that through our interpersonal contact. And I think temporary imperfections is a beautiful way of describing what we've been experiencing. And I didn't want to steal that from you, but nor did I want it to get lost before it was said.
Mi fa emozione quello che dici perché nel cooperative learning l'autore di una frase quando arriva come punto di arrivo di un processo di gruppo non è importante.
What you're saying really touches me, it moves me, because in cooperative learning, where there is a group and the group comes up with something, with a phrase or whatever, the person who actually speaks that phrase is not important. In particular, I felt the belonging. The belonging in this temporariness.
Il fatto di aver potuto distinguere, ma non solo nel piccolo gruppo, già ieri nel premesso.
And the fact of having been able to experience, not only in the small groups, but also yesterday in the introduction,
la differenza tra provvisorio e precario.
I was able to experience the difference between provisional and precariousness. Well, that's a gift, it's a gem, to put it in with your word.
Perché per chiudere la mia riflessione finale, prendo quello che pensavo questa mattina, la complessità non è patologia, non è solo
And for my closing statement, let's say, going back to what we were saying this morning about complexity is not pathological. It is complexity, quindi non è patologia. Hai detto un'altra cosa? Sì, okay. It's not pathology.
E questo in particolare, studiando la complessità, ho scoperto che la difficoltà a fare previsioni.
And in studying complexity, what I have found to be difficult is to make forecasts, to predict things.
Mentre invece io da piccolo ho imparato che occorre avere tutto già predefinito, predisposto, come dicevo in forma lineare.
And whereas for me as a child, I was taught to predict things, to have everything lined up in a row, let's say, and have, you know, things all worked out. And so this leads me to say that this space here, the learning conversations, represents a rich space that acts as a field of positive forces, creative forces. And what I'm taking home with me is lots of words and lots of conversations,
lots of communication
without actual words. There has been communication, but not in terms of words.
Perché il mio maestro di pedagogia diceva che c'è un tempo per imparare I frutti, un tempo per imparare I semi.
As my pedagogist, my teacher, used to say, there is a time for learning about fruits and there's a time for learning about seeds.
Grazie, era tanto che non mi commuovevo.
And thank you, because it was a long time since I last was so moved. I was quite impressed by what Rona said. And also by what Trudy and Cesare said. During these days, I have been in listening. I have been here listening, and right from the beginning, I had put myself in a totally open mode. And I wanted to thank everyone for the communication that occurred when we at some point actually gave ourselves the rhythm, the time, the pace.
Questo per me è stato molto comunicativo.
And this was a moment of great communication for me. And I felt a very contactful moment. I felt great contact. And I would like to thank everyone because it is as if I stepped into a woods. And little by little, I started paying attention to the branches swaying in the wind. And I started seeing the light filter through the leaves. Some little squirrels scuttling by. So this is the picture that I take home with me. And I wish to thank you for this.
Eu não vou, I will not try to translate in words my experience. I think that this is not possible. I really enjoy, especially each moment with the small groups, and I saw in each small group a deeper sharing, and this impacted me. For sure, I get something with me, but I can express. I think that if I use the words, I could be misunderstanding because it's my experience. And I would like to say thank you for Sylvie, for everything, for the welcome. Thank you for Benedetta. And very glad for Bert and Rosemary of Trudy to be here. And also for each one of you that we are engaged in a conversation, learning conversation. Thank you very much.
I feel a sense of gratitude because I was able to experience variety of culture, understanding about various concepts of TA, organizational, counseling, educational. So what I also take at this moment is your word on imperfection. That is something very nice. And your teacher saying of time to think of seed and sometime time to think of fruit. So that's very interesting, and I'm staying with that. Thank you.
I'm taking away a picture that I have in my head, an image that I've had in my head since yesterday. And this approach to different cultures, as if picturing the cultures as being coffers, as being boxes of jewels. boxes that I would like to open to discover what's inside. But what prevents me from doing this at times, from going and opening up these boxes, is fear. But then when I do have the courage to open up one of these boxes, I find lots of beautiful jewels. I think that meeting people from other cultures with other cultures is a way of learning to live.
Credo che le persone diverse possano veramente costruire qualcosa di più ricco.
I think that different people coming together can build something different thanks to their individual differences, their individuality. I too am taking home this word imperfection and also temporariness, temporary. And also another phrase that I think was spoken by Rosemary on approaching other people's cultures as travelers and not as tourists. Which means releasing ourselves of our own cultures in order to come truly into contact with the culture of the other. And I thank you all because I'm truly honored. I'm honored to have taken part. This is the first time that I've participated in one of these learning conversations. And one cultural difference that I have perceived is that many people from other cultures speak English, Italians don't. And so I've taken the resolve that now I have to change. And next time I want to be able to speak a bit of English. Thank you to you, all of you.
I'm tired a bit and I'm aware of having slept miserably two nights because of the noise. And I'm not a city type of person, I need some quietness. And how exhausting it is when I'm getting older and a bit deaf, always to try to get something out of this morning background and the trucks passing by. So sometimes I only understand 70% or so. I fill the gap with my fantasies, but I'm not sure whether I am right with that. And so I feel calm and because I have 11 hours to drive home, so I feel, how will I manage this? So I'm a bit already with my mind on the highway. So it's good at that stage. I don't have to come to a conclusion, and it was worthwhile what we did. And I thank you, especially Sylvie. You did a great job around all this, and certainly all the others who contributed to it.
just one sentence. I learned one thing, especially these 2 days, and it's that it's not only that there are not only the elements of the structure to look at. It begins with trying to put things into a structure. That was the first cultural attempt, and maybe it's worth trying not to do that every time, just getting into a situation without having a structure. And that's a big learning, and I thank you for that. Like, inside, I don't know what I can do with this, but so there's no structure for this learning.
For my own learning, how to deal with that fact. Having no structure can also be an attempt.
You should have asked me a lot for that to learn full time.
So I go home. Also with a lot of questions, with a lot of thinking, and with a lot of experience. And one of my tasks for myself was, because being reduced in speech of speaking, I observed more and I could more be with me and thinking what's going up in with me. And to have a position which I find very, very important for the going up with other cultures, observing without taking assumptions or decisions or feelings like anger or such things, the Martian position of Bern. And I think I exercised this here, and it was a good experience for me. And second is, I had a lot of meetings, a lot of discussions on different levels of time structure. And also this, I find it very interesting to see the difference between small talk, working phases, intimacy, deep conversations. And so I take home a lot of experience. Thank you all.
So first I want to add myself to the thank yous, primarily Sylvie, for your preparing and having this here, and for all contributions we had in the different roles. In these days, I think every one of us always does his or her best in the moment, the best he or she knows, and that's a base of a good coming together. My picture was thinking in Eric Berne's terms. He had this group theory where he developed certain stages that at the end of the group, the final or the best stage is that you have individual relationships to every group member, and not to see the group etiquetted in this is this subgroup, this is this subgroup, and this is this. And I experienced in the 3 days to the one-to-one contacts that all this kind of this one is from this country or from this vanished for me, and I had a one-to-one relationship to the people, and I think this is a gift for me to see this for everyone, what is the one-to-one, and not to have to cluster them in a certain event. That was different in the beginning. I think it's an interesting process that maybe we can learn from that for other international conversations. Thank you. so I have to look at that.
Thank you.
I too find it difficult to find the words to describe what I have experienced over the last 3 days. There are many thoughts and many feelings that I'm having. I was very much at ease because my way of learning is being in chaos at first and then some structure. And experiencing things or testing things out, experiencing them through with you through human contact. And the true learning for me will come in subsequent days and weeks, reflecting on what has happened here. Things changed when I came into contact with my feelings and I was in relationship. And what I'm taking home with me is a lot, but also a lot of calmness. I thank Sylvie and Rosemary and Bernd and everybody else. It has been an experience of co-creation at several levels. For me. Thank you.
I'm struck by the number of us that have said that finding the words is difficult, and that sometimes when we do find them, they may not communicate what we want. And I'm really struck by my experience of these 2.5 days is how much of our shared experience is non-verbal or below the surface or emerges in images, stories, metaphors, bodily sensations, patterns, this kind of thing. And that the potential to make meaning together is about our collective resilience in staying in relationship with whatever is emerging. So for me, there's two levels. We may feel okay, we may feel not okay. Patterns of okayness and not okayness emerge between individuals, between groups. It can be really hard to stay with it because obviously our own stories get triggered and we experience things that can be hard to manage. At the same time, feeling not okay is okay. For me, okayness is about being okay about not okayness, because part of being human is to be okay and not okay, and to shift. So my learning coming from here is that difference is human, diversity is human. The notion of a coherent narrative that we all share is not realistic. And that it may not, why? For me, there's something about how, in my work, let's say as a consultant, how can I, in my role, expand my capacity to be okay about not being okay so that I can help my clients to expand their capacity within, so that there's more room, not only in time, in literal time, but inside to hold different types of meaning as they emerge. And I think in myself, in these 2.5 days, I found myself wanting to get away. I felt not okay. Get away from. And then invited myself to be okay about that and see what happened. And there's something about the fact that I didn't leave is part of what happened between us. It's not just about me. There's something about this system that was resilient enough that we're all still here. And I find that really, I feel profoundly optimistic about that, actually. Yeah, I'll leave it at that. Thank you.
I think one of the learnings or reinforcements of learnings I take away is the vitality of contact. I love the way you said it, Liselotte. Lively. Very lively contact. It's great.
I know it now.
That's okay. It's just, it added something. It added something. And that contact, the importance of contact coming before contract, and the importance of contract. TA is really good on this. And I was thinking about Byrne's ideas about contract and culture. And he talks about contract as being part of the structures, the actual contract. It's part of the structures of a system. And negotiating and renegotiating and refining the contract is part of the dynamics of the system. And one of the ways he defined culture is how we, usually non-verbally, agree to ignore the contract. And I think that's a very interesting way to define culture. And I hear rumors there was some ignoring of the contracts many times. And I like that.
Se eu preciso, te peço. In these 3 days, I learn, and learn. Thank you with us. Very intensive my experience about culture, about peoples, about me and improve my work and my relationships in my groups, in my country. My experience in the last small group, very important. And real learned conversation. And a partir dessa experiência, I believe the continuum learning conversation. Because in this small group, real experience, learned conversation, different culture, and this real possibility, the contact culture, the begin. And mesmo ignorando contratos, nós conseguimos. But I agree this contact very important. Very important. Important includes for, say, now, não vamos cumprir o contrato, mas é importante que se diga. Thank you, with us, Sylvie, one more, Rosemary and Bern, because you begin the learned conversation. And this, in my experience, very important for me. Thank you. Thank you, Benedetta.
Like many of you, I'm at a loss of words to articulate what I'm experienced over the past 3 days and what I'm experiencing now. So I won't attempt to do so. It's all I can say is that it's been a very rich, intense 2.5 days. My coming here, this was my first experience of learning conversations, and my coming here was to be part of the experience, and so that's what I've done, in probably a rather passive way, but that's what I think that's where I felt right. And I very much like the idea of the seed, because I can't see the fruit at the moment. So I'm going to take that seed, it's planted, and I'll just wait and see what grows from it. Yeah. It'll probably start growing once I get up in my airplane tonight. So thank you, all of you, for this experience.
I'm with the fruit, actually. I'm with the fruits. that really touched me, the seed and the fruit, but I really feel I'm with the fruits. I actually have a really big tree of fruits at the moment, so I'm kind of very thoughtful about that. And gathering the fruit, which is a theme for me with gathering the harvest, as Rosemary knows. I've had some great conversations with people, you know, in the bigger group and smaller group, and in the evenings too. And I'm taking a lot away to be very thoughtful about. So I don't have a lot of words. I have a lot of felt experience, which I would just take away and reflect on. I think it's been a great experience. I haven't felt great all the time. I've had some lows. I felt not okay. And I've also felt okay. And that's a very interesting place to be. So I'm going to take that away. And thank you, Sylvie, for your help, and Rosemary, and Bernd, and everybody else. And yeah, that's it.
Okay, so I'm the last one to speak. It has been a fascinating experience. Kiche?
Benedetta deve anche parlare. Okay, I had a lot of very intense conversations with people, and this was very interesting and fruitful for me. But I'm a woman of language, I'm a journalist, and I struggle very much that the language of all of us is not the same. And yes, therefore I'm sometimes looking for words, and it would be very, I would very like to be before Babylon, so it would be easier to understand each other, even if I agree that there's a lot of non-verbal conversation. But beside of all of this, I'm very happy that I had been part of this conversation. Okay?
Parlo in italiano, però. Così tu conosci.
Vai. Vabbè, io non ho assolutamente conoscenza di organizzazione, perché studio psicoterapia.
So I don't have any experience with organizations because I study TA therapy, in psychotherapy.
Esatto, quindi la possibilità di essere qui me l'ha data CD. Diciamo non avevo proprio idea di cosa fosse.
And Sylvie gave me the opportunity, the possibility of being here, but I had no idea what these conversations were about. So apart from the work I was doing behind the scenes, I was really very, very happy to be have a glimpse and see the type of work that is done here, which is very fascinating. So thank you to you all. Yes, okay, all right. So this has been a wonderful experience for me as well, because I knew absolutely nothing about the learning conversations, and I've learned things as I've gone along. So it's a totally new world. I didn't know there was so much going on in organizational TA, because I work mainly with psychotherapists, and I thought that it was all there, and that was where it was all. So I've learned a lot. I've really learned a lot, and I thank Sylvie. It's been very intense, because the pacing, the noise, the traffic, the people speaking at the same time, it was very tiring. So I'm really very, very tired, but I'm happy. Allora.
mille grazie. Okay, so this has been a fascinating experience for me, extremely demanding on many levels, and very interesting in terms of the vision that I had in mind about culture and relationships in a system, relationships within a system, as ongoing processes, micro processes of adjustment, which go on all the time to help us understand each other. And I experience also many of the things that you mentioned, that some of you mentioned they had experienced, and at the same time, a lot of richness. And I am I'm very grateful also to, and I want to thank Bern and Rosemary, because it has been wonderful to be able to move together in a sort of dance. I have the feeling that we have moved together in a sort of dance. Sometimes we are not dancing so accordingly together.
Toes get
trodden. However, we dance together, and I think that this is part that was conveyed to the group, really, our sort of dance together and our sort of ongoing micro adjustments. We did a lot of intermediate talking. And the fascinating thing also was this of changing and readjusting all the time the structure that we had thought at the beginning. At the beginning, we shared the general program, and then we readjusted it all the time along the way and ongoing based on what was going on. I also want to thank everyone, all the participants really, because I felt also there was some connection when we were exchanging all those mails before the learning conversations. And I want to thank Frieder, because I'm a totally non-technological person, you may have noticed that, and he introduced me in the world of technology, offering suggestions all the time, which made me think a lot, and which gave me the opportunity of thinking about using more opportunities. So this has been a definite new learning for me, opening a new world. I don't know how more technological I can become or I will become. However, it's a good beginning. And I want to thank Enya for her flexibility. It has not been easy throughout these days. And the, I think the Italians also, it's not because I'm Italian, but I think they did beautifully in adapting to the complex structure and not knowing the language and being here. And Benedetta, thank you very much for the wonderful job you did. And for her doing it very also independently. She picked up what needed to be done and went ahead, which is wonderful, without me even saying it. So to our next ideas, visions, processes, etc. And one last thing I want to say is, and I will finish because it's time to go, is this thing about okayness and non-okayness and the TA world, etc., etc. I happened to be with prominent TA people a few months ago, and somebody all of a sudden along the way was telling me, oh, this shitty thing about okayness. I think it's a fucking shitty thing. It really, you know, bothers me. And I was shocked because I think this is really the foundation, and I think this is really the basis that we had on the back of our minds in working here. And I think really that disagreeing is an okay thing. And I think what I don't know if this is what Ellen may have mentioned when she was talking about being it okay to be non-okay. The way I rephrase it is being okay in disagreeing with more than one thing, disagreeing and disobeying to a number of things. And I think that's an interesting perspective that will make me think a lot also about the thoughts that were generated for me throughout the comments of the people in the small group. So a definite number of learnings and richness of learning. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Who has
intention to go to Brazil?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, also I.
One. Four, five. I think maybe Lizzie.
Six. Yeah, Lizzie said she was interested also.
Yeah.
Six.
Seven.
And
some money.
About eight people. Mm-hmm. Did you get Cesare?
Cesare also.
Mm-hmm. And I think there will be some others.
Yeah. Okay, arrivederci.
Ciao.
Ciao.